A trouble? Hello, my name is Grace. Today I'm going to read the Bible story. A trouble test from Abraham. God had put Abraham through two very difficult tests, having to journey into the unknown and having to wait for so long for he and Sarah to have a child. But beloved son Isaac was about 11 years old. God delivered Abraham some shattering news. I want you to take your son to Moriah, to a place that I will show you. God told Abraham, and offer me and sacrifice. I don't want you to kill and burn a goat or a lamb. Also, I want you to sacrifice Isaac. Abraham was appalled, but God had spoken clearly, and Abraham was quite sure what he wanted. Next morning, with a joy in his heart, servant to make ready to go with firewood and provisions packed onto a donkey. Abraham told Isaac they were going on a trip, and they set off into the desert for 2 days. Abraham walked closer to the place where he was to perform the terrible deed. Then, on the third day of traveling, they come to the foot of a hill. And Abraham knew it was the place God meet. You stay here with the donkey, Abraham told the servant. I am going up the hill with Isaac to pray and make an offering to God. Isaac hurried to help unloading the donkey and lifting up the heavy bundle of wood they would need to burn the sacrifice. Abraham carried a sharp knife and a pot of red hot coals of starting the fire. Then the old man and his son began sorry, I have a cough. Climbing higher and higher until they could no longer see the servants waiting. below. At last, they came to a little clearing, and Abram stopped it and said, "A strange, tense voice. Here's the spot. Father, we're God. We have got the wood and clothes to light the fire, but we have forgotten to bring an animal to sacrifice," pointed out Isaac. Abram couldn't bring himself to meet his son's eyes. "God will give us the animal," he said, his voice cracking with sorrow. Then the two workers walked side by side to make an altar from stone and the rack the firewood on top of it. Finally, the time had come for Abram to do the unthinkable. Imagine Isaac's terror when his father keep him up and lift him onto the wood, realizing that he was to be the sacrifice in altar. Abram raised his knife, hung, and took a deep breath, sleeping himself to like his own son, whom he loved so much. Just as he was about to plunge the blood, downward, "Stop!" boomed a voice from heaven into Abram's mind. Abram knew it was an angel speaking. "You have proved that you love God properly by showing you were ready to sacrifice your son just because he said so. That is enough. Do not harm Isaac." Abraham dropped the knife. His shaking hands could hardly untie the rope and bounded Isaac, weeping so hard he thought his chest would burst. He held his beloved son and asked for his forgiveness. Sought his tears, Abraham caught sight of a nearby bushing shaking. A ram was caught in it. "You see, Isaac, I told you that God won't give us an animal for the sacrifice." Abraham went over the colt. The ram and offered it in Isaac's place. When Abraham and his son had finished praying, they walked down the hill and returned home together. Wow! Next time, I will also only listen to God, what He says. Like God said to Abraham, sacrifice me Isaac. And Abraham was very, very sad to do, but he knew God. He trusted God. And he was going to sacrifice Isaac, but God said stop. So Isaac and Abraham is happily living ever. And when he didn't listen to God, and he will not sacrifice, I think God will take Isaac because he was testing Abraham, and there is Isaac. I think Abraham is very sad to kill Isaac. And Isaac was also not shouting or like that, because he knew his dad's true love of God, and he was just laying on the altar, and Abraham was going to, but God said stop, right? Next time we also have to listen to God, then God will give us more good things. Yes, next time I will read a tale of twin brothers. It is fun, then bye.